so is the NBA. Hey, thanks for joining us on 2K Sports. With Greg Anthony and Hall of Famer Doris Burke, this is Kevin Harlan. And joining us on the sidelines, another Hall of Famer, David Aldridge. DA, it's all yours.
Well, if you ask Carl Anthony Towns, his greatest strength is his versatility. He said, "My dad taught it to me at a young age, and it's made my transition at every step of my career comfortable, having the fundamentals and foundation. I don't limit myself. I try to be great at all skills." Kevin?
Yeah, terrific attitude. It makes him very tough to handle. David, thank you. And a quick look here at some of the numbers for Leonard.
And he's gone dry over the past 10 games, guys. His scoring is way down, and he can't seem to fight his way out of the slump. He better get it going tonight, or they'll start losing patience with him.
And the Clippers starting five. They've got Paul George. Morris is out there with Kawhi Leonard. Then it's Patrick Beverley. And it's Zubats in at the five. And for the Timberwolves, they've got James Johnson. Russell is out there with Culver. Then there's Towns, and it's Okogie in at the three slot. What great athleticism with both these teams. I mean, every move is so graceful, so skilled. I mean, majestic.
It is, Kevin. There's an explosiveness. There's this speed that is absolutely incredible to watch. Every possession up and down the floor could have the potential highlight reel.
The three from George connects from three-point range. George has got the first 3 points tonight for the Clippers. Now Russell. There's the pass to Culver. Down to five on the shot clock, and they pick up two.
And for me, guys, this is an area that Culver should utilize more often, showing off that incredible feel with the jumper.
Now here's Leonard. 14 points from him the last game against Miami.
And you know, guys, the other thing I really appreciated about his effort in that game was the effort and work on the glass. What a well-rounded performance.
Here is Russell. Kawhi Leonard making his last shot. Russell dishes to Towns. Now, here's Culver, defended by George. A nice shot by Culver.
And looking good there from distance. Culver fundamentally sound with his jumper.
First quarter, about a minute and a half in. Leonard draws the double. Nobody near George. And again, Los Angeles with the triple.
And guys, getting into a nice groove here, starting to feel it.
And this is partly what the game has become, right? A matter of dueling three-point opportunities.
And it's Johnson with the jam.
When Russell gets his teammates involved, it makes this entire team better, and it'll make him more effective at the point position.
Passes it to Morris. Here's George, and he banks in the layup. George has got 8 points.
Boy, they came ready to play. That's four straight buckets to start the game.
Stolen by Beverley. If you're just tuning in, we've played about 2.5 minutes here in the first, and the shot goes down.
Well, this guy's a capable scorer from the interior. Marcus Morris, adept at using that size and touch to his advantage.
Here's Towns. Lays it up off the glass.
Just setting the tone with an aggressive move to the rack. And where's the help defensively?
To me, Greg, that's a complete lack of communication on that side of the ball. These guys need to be talking to each other.
Here's Beverley after the made shot from Carl Anthony Towns. Leonard with the bucket.
Kawhi Leonard's length lets him play bigger than his size.
Timberwolves trail by five. Now, here is Russell. 17 points for him last game against Atlanta. Fires the three. Timberwolves with a fresh shot clock. Here's Johnson. His second shot goes in, off to a good start, 2 for 2.
Well, you have to be cognizant of where people are when the shot goes up. Defenders not blocking out in that instance.
Here's Leonard. Zubac trying to break loose. And that one's good. Leonard, he has six.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
Now, here's Culver, defended by George. Pass to Russell. Three-pointer. It's hauled in by George. Clippers leading by five. Beverly wide open. A three-pointer off the mark. Towns finds Russell. Back to Towns. And the call is going to be, yes, it is, an illegal screen.
When a pick like that is questionable and creates that much of an advantage for the offense, you have to blow the whistle.
I don't think there's any question, Greg. There are so many rules that favor the offense these days. You've got to be able to equal things out when an illegal screen is set.
And now here's Johnson, the fast break chance. And it's sent back by George.
Paul George, tremendous vertical. Kevin, how fast does he get off his feet?
Shoots over Culver. Los Angeles with another miss.
Well, defenses are content to give up the mid-range, right? It's not the high percentage restricted area or the three. You can see they're prepared to give up that shot.
Okogie misses.
Oh, that's terrific defense there. That's how you protect the rim.
A superstar summer, Greg, for the Los Angeles Clippers in Kawhi Leonard and in Paul George. Greg, they have two elite wings, great defenders in their prime.
Give them credit, but also Kawhi Leonard pushing the levers behind the scenes. He wanted another superstar to join him in recruiting Paul George, who still had 2 years left on his deal in OKC. Kawhi took unprecedented control of his free agent destiny.
Take a break. Two shots.
No good on that one.
Well, for so much of what Paul George brings to the table, you have to start with his defensive impact. He is one of the top defenders in the league at his position, if not the best.
You look at George with all he does, Greg, you sometimes forget how good his perimeter defense is.
Well, I mean, his teammates and coaches won't ever forget about the impact he has on that end. Even when George isn't scoring or the shot isn't falling, he is still a monster on the floor just with his defense alone.
Minnesota calls timeout. As the teams head into this timeout, a chance for the coaches now to map out some plays for the next few minutes and a chance for the players to rehydrate with some Gatorade. That's important if they want to make sure they don't wear down later in the game.
Absolutely. Over the course of a game, you have to stay hydrated.
Outside, Towns. Pass to Okogie. Just five on the clock. Out of bounds, Timberwolves ball as Minnesota keeps possession. Already it's February. Hard to believe. Let's see how the West is matching up. You take a look at Los Angeles. They're sitting pretty, second place, and looking to take the top spot. Of course, there's the Timberwolves, just way behind.
And when you look at the Clippers, every NBA season, there's always going to be some big surprises in store. And I think this season, they'd have to be considered one of the biggest of them all.
Oh, no question. And we're deep enough into the season to know, hey, this hasn't happened by accident. They are genuine contenders here.
Timberwolves trail by six. They could use a bucket. Towns down low. Zubac defending. And Towns gets it to go.
Karl Anthony Towns can be a 20-10 guy consistently. This guy is a workhorse on the glass.
And so it's Leonard with it. He'll bring it up for Los Angeles. They come in fresh off a win against the Heat.
Yeah, torrid shooting in that one. Some of it was good play calling. Some of it was just making tough shots.
Well, give credit to a couple of their guys for their complete locked-in nature. They were just focused, and they made everything they looked at.
Now, here's George after D'Angelo Russell's miss. Here's Zubats, and there's the bucket. Stand with it on the offensive glass, getting it done.
Just a grinder, always doing the dirty work on the offensive glass, and that's one of the things he brings to the table.
Here's Okogie. He's covered by Leonard. Kicks it to Culver. And the ball travels out of bounds. It was last touched by George. Now a chance to see the NBA leaders in steals. Fifth best, Kawhi Leonard.
And he's been a rock for them defensively. Just so many steals for him this year, and so many of them have been in key moments for his team.
Johnson outside, over Morris. Great touch on the 16-footer. Johnson's got 6 points. Los Angeles leading by four. So timeout called here, the first for Los Angeles.
You know, Doris, I know your style of play at Providence was one of aggressiveness, a lot of instinct, a lot of smarts, great skill. But I think you also have an appreciation for the players that are real scrappy on the floor.
What I love, Kevin, are guys who can influence the game without having incredible offensive skill. So a guy like Patrick Beverley, so a little bit undersized, but would you like to have that guy pick you up at 94 feet, be in your grill and in your face like he gives no quarter, he gives no concessions? If he were checking Kevin Harlan, my goodness, you'd have a long night.
That would be a torture chamber. I agree with you.
And Leonard gets it to go.
And their offense already in a flow, some stellar shooting to jump out to this lead.
And it's Turner off the drive. Here's Towns. Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul.
You get the sense that Karl Anthony Towns, as young as he is, knows he can be the best player in the league. There isn't a phase on the offensive end from which he can't score it.
Well, Doris, no doubt that Karl Anthony Towns is the star of his team right now and in the future.
I think, Kevin, for all the drama and all the turnover we have seen, the one constant has been Karl Anthony Towns' productivity. The question now for the team is, how do they build a title contender around him?
Now, here's Shamet. 23 points for him the last game against Miami.
Well, you also have to credit the way he controlled the pace of the game and was able to create for his teammates.
Here's Cram, following the score by Lou Williams. Hernan Gomez passes to Turner. Over Williams. The shot, no good. And the Clippers will come the other way. And that one's good, Shamet. And the Clippers lead by eight.
And really, it's been a major aspect of their offense in the early stages here. Their success working the ball inside and getting points from close range.
And Towns gets it to go.
Well, takes contact, keeps his balance. Nice finish by Towns.
Los Angeles leading by six. Shamet the pass to Harrell. And there's a foul called on Alan Cram. That's his first foul. And the pass to Shamet. Teardrop shot, and he sinks the layup. Shamet's got his second basket of the night.
Pretty much all of their buckets coming from inside the paint now.
Now here's Cram. Tight defense on him, and Jamichael Green picks up the foul. That is his first foul of the game. Here's Turner, still getting warmed up offensively. No scoring yet from him. Four on the shot clock. Towns, no luck. Clippers leading by eight. Here's Shamet. Up and in on the layup. Shamet's got 6 points.
They're getting on a roll inside. Their last three field goals have come from the paint.
Hernan Gomez with the ball. Passes it to Turner. Wide open shot is on the money.
It goes down, but with no defender near him, no need to go to the fadeaway.
And here is Williams. A 14-point game for him in the win against Miami. Here's Green, and it's sent back by Turner. And they get it back, and the basket is good.
And now six straight points here coming on the inside.
Timberwolves trail by 10. Now Crabb. He averages about 5 points a game. Pass to Turner. Here's Spellman. Nice ball movement by Minnesota. Shot clock at 6. Towns, no luck.
Cannot believe he missed that. I'm sure he can't either.
I agree. Here's Mann. Rebounded by the Timberwolves.
That's a surprise. I mean, really out of character for him to miss when the defense is not right up on it.
Yep, that one goes.
Alan Crabb doing work on the interior, sir. Okay.
Now, here's Shamet. He's got 6. Harrell kicks to Williams. In the corner, Shamet with it. That 3 off the mark. Timberwolves trail. 43 seconds left to play in the first. Hernan Gomez passes to Turner. And the rejection by Harrell.
No doubt it's been a bit of a struggle for him here in this quarter in terms of scoring.
And the Timberwolves making a change here. Beasley's checked in, and the Clippers with a change here, too. Magruder's checked in. Minnesota's gone, 1 of 3 from beyond the arc so far in the game. Shot clock and game clock separated by less than 6 seconds. Beasley outside. Pass to Turner, and stolen by Harrell. And pushing it up, here's Los Angeles. Here's Magruder. Gets it to go from beyond the arc. And the Clippers lead by 11.
Yeah, we're seeing some fireworks from them already.
Well, what I love is the game plan has been solid from the opening tip. And guys are making their shots. That's critical.
And there it is for him.
I'll tell you what, it's hard to stop Karl-Anthony Towns when he's looking to score. He's got every trick at his arsenal.
Paul George, he's been the guy making things happen for the L.A. Clippers. He finishes with 9 points in the quarter. The D is having all sorts of problems with him. And don't go away. We'll be right back. All-star big man Karl-Anthony Towns is hungry to maximize his potential.
I want to be the best player who ever played. And I feel that I could do that. I think I have the God-given talent and the God-given abilities to make it happen. And I have total confidence in myself every single day. I wake up that I could be the greatest player who ever played. I know if I continue to put the work ethic in and continue to do all the little things I need to do, I could find myself in that conversation. But, you know, obviously I got to learn every single day and never take no days for granted.
His coaches, Greg, and teammates love hearing that.
And how can you not? I mean, that kind of drive is special. And with his tools and potential, hard to put a ceiling on just how good he can be.
And welcome back to the second quarter of action. Plenty of basketball left to play, but this one has been one-sided so far. And taking a look at Los Angeles's performance here, what have they been doing or not doing?
Impressive start. They came in with a well-conceived game plan and have executed.
What terrific work at the offensive end. They have built some early momentum here.
Setting the floor for the Clippers. Williams and Shamet are the guard set. Harrell is out there with Jermichael Green, and it's Magruder in at the small forward position.
Impressive awareness from Karl-Anthony Towns. Dependable at finding teammates with a terrific look there.
Williams looking over the floor, 13 feet away, and he gets the jumper to drop. Williams has got his second bucket of the night.
Oh, great move there. That spin just dusted the defense.
I think one thing you have to love about the Timberwolves, their aggression on the offensive end. This is a team that has been top 10 in free throw attempts over the last 8 years, and when they get to the line, they do convert.
And part of why the Wolves get to the line so much, they take a lot of two-point shots.
And that's a trade-off, right, Kev? We all know the analytics like the three-point shot. They like restricted area twos. But the best way to get to the line is to challenge the teeth of that defense. You can't do that from 25 feet away, guys. Get there!
Shamet on the wing. He kicks to Harrell. The pass to Green. Shot clock at 5. Outside Williams. A three-pointer, no good. And it's Towns with the ball. He'll bring it up for the Timberwolves. 7-point differential. And it's Beasley finishing it off.
And hard to decide which was better, the pass, the catch, or the slam.
There's no wrong answer. Sensational alley-oop. Here's Williams. And the rejection by Towns.
A terrific effort by Towns. Sticks with the play and sends it back.
Attacking in transition, the most consistent way to generate easy looks.
The very definition of quality transition offense. If it can end at the cup, it's exactly where you want it.
Pass to Harrell. Good for the basket. Starting off 1-for-1 with that shot.
And they keep hammering away at him inside, forcing the ball into the paint.
Let's go now to the sideline and catch up with David Aldridge.
Well, guys, one of the things that the NBA has been forward-thinking about is always accepting new ideas. And they've got a bunch of them on the table in recent weeks. A mid-season tournament, a postseason play-in tournament, maybe even reducing the 82-game regular season schedule. Now, all of these would be very bold moves, but Commissioner Adam Silver has always demonstrated a willingness to think outside the box. Kevin?
VA, great assessment. Good report. Thank you so much. Minnesota making some changes. Johnson, he's checked in for Amari Spellman. Culver comes in for Alan Crabb. And it's Russell in for Turner. Big group substitution here for the Clippers. Morris is checked in for Green. Leonard comes in for Rodney Magruder. Paul George, he's checked in for Landry Shamet. And it's Patrick Beverley in for Lou Williams.
How about the recognition from Culver? Terrific at realizing when the defense has broken down.
Here's Leonard. Los Angeles with another miss.
Well, he's a quality mid-range shooter, but he can't get that one to go.
And George gets the whistle that time. That's his first foul. Pass to Russell. Back to Towns. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line. It's going to be on Montrezl Harrell.
We've talked about this guy's ability to get to the free throw line. Towns in incredibly tough cover.
He's shooting free throws, number 4 in 5 here. And it's tied up with that one.
And you look at how Towns is so effective on offense. And it's because he really has the entire package for a big man. Back to the basket, facing up, playing outside or in, off the bounce or on the catch. This guy can do it all.
And some hang time on the rim. Puts a little cherry on the top of that slam.
Well, those kind of displays of strength can get one team rolling. Back to Russell. Outside, Towns. Here's Culver. See that time from Leonard. And Greg, as you said, it's the skill level of Towns at his young age that is so incredible.
Very capable three-ball shooter, but he likes backing you down on the block as well. You step back and look at what he can do for a team, and there aren't really any holes in his game.
Here's Culver. He doesn't hit that one. Excellent D there from George. Here's Leonard. Rebound Minnesota. Last time they came together was in Los Angeles, where they fell to the Clippers.
Yeah, and their last time out against this club, turnovers really did them in. Just way too many mistakes.
They were forced into tons of sloppy play, and I think they'll be looking to be more composed tonight.
And the bucket is good. 3-point play chance here for him.
Now, this is a guy who's averaged over 6 rebounds per game during his career. This guy, one of the better rebounding small forwards we have.
And the Raptors went all in trading for Kawhi Leonard last season, Doris. Great talent surrounding him in Toronto, but this past summer, he decided to move on.
But, Kevin, a championship makes the gamble worthwhile if you were Toronto. For Kawhi, any team he plays on is going to have a chance to win. And now this young man, a champion, starts a new chapter. Boy, you think back to the quadriceps injury that derailed almost all of the 2018 season for Kawhi Leonard. I'll tell you, he is back to peak form and reminding us that he is elite on both the offensive and defensive ends.
Russell, nice shot from 10 feet out.
Well, this is a main strength of D'Angelo Russell. When he gets room to shoot from the mid-range, there's no hesitation.
Beverly deciding where to go with it. High, arcing shot. That one drops for him. Beverly's got 4 this quarter. And you talk about the best two-way player in the NBA. I think a lot of people, Doris, would put Kawhi Leonard at the top of that list.
Let's remember, Kawhi's a former Defensive Player of the Year, averaging over 25 points a game for a season. He doesn't necessarily wow you with his eye-popping athleticism, but the reality is this, Kawhi Leonard is a multi-time champion.
That one good for 2.
Well, guys, Kawhi may not have averaged 20 points per game until his 5th season, but now it happens with regularity.
Back to Russell. Pass to Culver. And here's Towns. Launches it. Kawhi Leonard with the rebound. Leonard's got 4 rebounds in this game. Loads it up there for Harrell. And it's out of bounds. The Clippers able to retain possession here.
And let's check out the numbers for Beverly. How his last 10 games have gone. He's right around 9 points a night, 4 assists, and 4 rebounds. Well, fans of this team will take this kind of production from him without hesitation.
I tell you, he has been a solid contributor. They have called his number, and he has delivered for them.
Timberwolves trail by 7. Down low. And finished off by Hernan Gomez.
And no doubt they'd love to see him get a lot more of those opportunities.
And that deficit will go away quickly if he does, Greg. Here's Leonard. Props in the layup for 2. Leonard's got 15 points.
They're finding lanes to the hoop now with consistency. 5 buckets in a row from the paint.
The pass to Okogie. Now, here is Russell. Four on the clock over Morris. And it's Russell missing. Clippers leading by 7. It's George on the wing. That's good, and it's Leonard with the assist. Leonard's got his 4th assist with that last one here tonight. Timberwolves shooting at 51%. Really solid. Culver passes to Johnson. Feeds it to Culver. And it's sent back by George.
And I'll tell you, they're going to need more from this guy if they're going to cut into this deficit.
Passes to Beverly. Right side, Leonard. Makes it off the glass. Beverly's got the lead up to 11 now for Los Angeles.
Well, we know Kawhi will always attract lots of defensive attention, which puts him in a position to find his teammates. Pretty pass.
Minnesota calls timeout. They're coming into this game off that recent loss to Atlanta.
Rough game defensively. I mean, they lost a lot of the individual matchups, and the help was slow to rotate.
I'll tell you this, Greg. If you're going to allow your opponent to make that many shots, you have got to be as solid on the offensive end. And clearly, they were not.
Johnson, that's for 2. The Timberwolves, again, can't hit. And here are the Clippers. They're on a 17-6 run. Sinks the triple.
That's his first triple of the second period. 3rd of the game.
Beverly against Russell. That one's good. Maybe that'll get him going after a 2-for-6 start.
Well, he's getting better at absorbing contact. Finishes like this prove Russell is a tough, dynamic competitor.
George passes to Leonard. Rebound, Minnesota. On the wing, Johnson shoots the three. Good for another bucket. He's made half a dozen now, 6-for-8 on the night.
That's the kind of D that you're not going to find success with, guys. They've got to get a hand in the face.
Leonard inside. He's got 15. Bucket is good. Leonard's got 17.
I mean, he's just been brilliant today, guys. And it was the same exact story last time out. And you think about the Wolves' history. KG, clearly their best player. But Big Cat has a chance to reach that level someday.
He does, Greg. And I think we always look through KG's legacy being defined by passion, commitment, and leadership. That was as important as his basketball skill. Karl Anthony Towns is similarly talented, right? I think the key is he just needs to find consistency. That's the last step.
Good ball movement here by the Clippers. Man, and again, Los Angeles with the triple.
Not the biggest fan of that shot, but he had the space to get it off. So why not?
Johnson surveying the floor. Russell dishes to Culver. Pass to Okogie. 6 to shoot. The Clippers grab the miss. Zubats has got 4 rebounds now tonight. And taken away by Johnson. Pass to Okogie. 1:43 left now here in the second. And here's Hernan Gomez outside. That one's off. He's now 1-for-2. Los Angeles leading by 12. And there's the pass to Zubats. Here's Beverly. He's got 6. 5 to shoot. And that'll be 2 free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
And throughout his career, Beverly has remained a pest, an aggressive defender that no one likes having him guard.
The Clippers have shot 2 of 3 from the free throw line tonight.
Yeah, looking over their percentage on the season, I think they will be thrilled with the number in terms of their free throw percentage, 79.
Shooting 2.
That's good from Beverly. Some changes for Minnesota. Omari Spellman has come in for Johnson. Turner comes in for Josh Okogie. And Krebs subbed in for Culver. Green, he's checked in for Los Angeles. Williams comes in for George. And so he's able to get 1 of 2. Timberwolves trail by 13. Passes it to Russell. And the slam dunk by Russell.
D'Angelo Russell rises up and drops the hammer.
Los Angeles has gone 5 of 9 when they put up the 3-point shot tonight. Pass to Mann. Beverly with the ball. Outside Leonard. From deep 3-point range, and it's Russell with the rebound.
And when you are as good a shooter as he is, you have the confidence. You have to have the confidence to take that shot. It might not always fall.
And for most guys, I think you only want to take that shot if you've hit a few in a row. That is absolutely a heat check.
They need a bucket in a big way here to regain some confidence.
And he trims the lead to single digits. Russell's got 11.
And they are absolutely stroking it from beyond the arc.
Leonard with the ball. He's got 17. From the arc. Good on the 3-point shot. Leonard's got 12 now in this quarter.
Yeah, just had a feeling Kawhi Leonard would respond with a three of his own. Beautiful.
And so it's Los Angeles. Their lead at 11 points to end the quarter. They're playing a bruising game inside, and it's working for them. It's time now to go court. Thank you, David. And we'll be back for the third quarter of action following halftime.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey, everybody. Kawhi Leonard is having one of those nights. He had 20 points, 5 rebounds, and 6 assists. In their previous game, he had a performance he said he wanted to put behind him quickly. And so far, he's doing just that with the nice first half he had here. And let us get your thoughts, big fella, on the Clippers.
I'm not surprised. Kawhi Leonard, usually getting it done on both ends, can give you 20, 30, 40 points a night and lock down the opponent's best scorer. True superstar.
Kenny. And that's a wrap.
Well, we've got a second half of basketball for you. We think it's going to be pretty good. A big comeback, though, is needed for this game to be competitive, and it probably has to happen quickly. Kawhi Leonard really has his fingerprints all over this one.
No problems fighting his way to the rim in this one. A lot of points in close.
And part of that has to do with his mindset. He has been looking to push the action at every opportunity, and he has been in attack mode all night.
Third quarter action getting rolling right now, brought to you by Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. Here's who's on the floor. So on the floor for Minnesota, we've got D'Angelo Russell. Johnson is out there with Karl Anthony Towns. Then it's Culver, and it's Okogie in at the three.
You know, a lot of coaches might let you hear it for taking the three-pointer on the break, but I like the decision there. The D had already collapsed inside. Well, D'Angelo Russell, one of the best mid-range scorers you'll see. He's got the floater game, the pull-up game, and with his arsenal, he can get a shot at any time.
Inside, and the dunk by Towns.
Well, Karl Anthony Towns is cooking right now, and the defense has nothing for him.
George passes to Zubats. Leonard against Johnson. And it's Leonard missing. And you know, Doris, another thing about D'Angelo Russell, he's not afraid of the big moment.
Kevin, he has proven that he is willing to take and make big shots. He doesn't necessarily beat you with tremendous athleticism, but it's his basketball skill that sets him apart.
Here's Leonard. Solid play in the low block, and that one's good. Leonard's got 4 points in the quarter.
This guy is cooking right now. He is leading them on the offensive end as they remain in front here.
Russell inside, defended by Beverly.
Boy, in that close, he's almost automatic. Boy, that's pretty good defense. Wow.
And taken away by Johnson. And we're just about 2 minutes into the second half now. Here's Okogie. He's covered by Leonard. Leonard with the steal. Now the Clippers moving it up. Leonard with the ball. And George with the stuff.
Well, we know that Paul George understands there's a certain point in the game when he's got to take over, and he's doing it now.
Okogie, the pass to Culver. Pass to Okogie. Puts up a three. Timberwolves keep it alive. And so George will bring it up for the Clippers. They've led by as many as 14 points. Now let's go to the sideline and catch up with our Hall of Famer, David Aldridge.
Well, Kevin, last season the G League tested out an expansion of the clear path rule. And now that expansion is making its way to the NBA. It should discourage those intentional fouls that slow up teams on the fast break. Fans wanted it, and analysts clamored for it. That will allow the amazing athletes in this league more opportunities to show what they can do in the fast break.
You're right, David. A welcome change. Thank you.
Well, Marcus Morris, the frame and the length to block shots, that's pretty.
Malik Beasley, he's checked in for Josh Okogie. And then for the Clippers, Harrell comes in for Ivica Zubac. And Landry Shamet subbed in for Leonard. And out of bounds as Los Angeles gains possession. And here is the 2K leaderboard with the list of the NBA's top rebounding teams this season. The Clippers in second.
You know, it's not necessarily a glamour stat, but make no mistake, their top-notch board work has been a huge key to their success.
Now, here's Beverly. Not a lot of room. Floats one up. A rebound by the Timberwolves. Towns has got rebound number 8 here tonight in the game. Here's Russell. It's hauled in by George. George has got his 4th rebound with that last one here tonight. Here's Beverly. Sweet little floater. Beverly's got 9 points.
Oh, great production on the interior right now. 8 straight from inside.
Russell against Beverly. Russell kicks to Johnson. Now the pass to Culver. There's the dish to Towns. 6 on the shot clock. Russell from long range. Rebound by Harrell. Harrell's got his 5th rebound in this one. Beverly against Russell. And the rejection by Towns. Beasley for 3. And it's the Clippers with the rebound. Their next game is in Cleveland, taking on the Cavaliers. That'll be the 2nd on the road in the midst of this long 4-game road stand.
Well, an aggressive player at the rim. Paul George has the kind of athleticism to make a defense look silly.
Culver passes to Towns. The lead pass was put in just the right spot. Towns has got 4 points now in the quarter. George, you graduated as your college's all-time assist leader. Talk about some of the key traits of a great playmaker.
I think historically speaking, when we think about great lead guards, Kevin, we talk about unselfishness, vision, patience. Who are the players that make their teammates better? Though probably the one underrated aspect of a point guard to me, Kevin, is communication. Are you constantly looking for opportunities to communicate to your teammates, make them feel good about themselves, give them confidence? That, to me, is probably the most underrated aspect of it.
And Doris, when you played, you took such great pride in each and every one of those things.
I did. I loved trying to make my teammates better. It feels great to make somebody feel good.
And they've only got a slight edge on the boards, but it just feels a lot bigger.
Here's George, and that one's in. He's only missed 3 of 13.
And that keeps him perfect from the field this quarter.
Some tough offensive sets. They want to turn it around.
Yeah, right now you just need a bucket to get some momentum.
Culver's shot is off.
Boy, that's the kind of look this offense is designed to create. That's just a tough miss.
Shamet kicks to Beverly. Back to Shamet. Fires from deep. That shot off. So Minnesota will take it the other way. Towns dishes to Culver. Here's Russell. Nice shot from 10 feet out. Russell's got 18 points in the game.
Okay, D'Angelo. Russell mixing in a little interior work. Not bashful.
And the Clippers call time here.
Yet another player from the 2019 draft class who wasn't a top high school recruit. Jarrett Culver, 3-star guy, thin, unrefined, but in that sophomore year of college, boy, did he surprise some folks.
Some changes for Minnesota. Omari Spellman comes in for James Johnson, and Krabs subbed in for Culver. The Clippers also making some changes. Rodney Magruder comes in for George. Lou Williams is subbed in for Patrick Beverly. Pass to Magruder. From deep, Minnesota with the rebound. Towns has got 10 rebounds here tonight. So active. And Greg, when you talk about Culver, the one thing he did show in high school and again showed at Texas Tech, the ability to score.
Yeah, and he creates and makes shots against great defenders. Every team in the NBA is looking for that. His jumper, his handle, his ability to move without the ball, already NBA level stuff.
Timberwolves trail by 9. To the inside. Spellman
strong move to the 10, trying to get his guys going.
Hard not to get motivated, GA, right when your teammate makes that kind of play.
Where was the defense? No help. You can't afford to give up these kinds of buckets.
Morris finds Williams. Floats one. He takes it up and lays it in. He's got six.
Well, the touch and the focus. What a pretty move in the lane.
Pass to Crab. Here's Towns, and the dunk by Towns.
Well, leaving no doubt on that one, the explosiveness of Cat.
Los Angeles leading by seven. And here is Williams. 6 points for him. Here's Harrell. A stupendous finish in traffic. Harrell's got his second bucket of the night. And so it's Russell with it. He'll bring it up for the Minnesota Timberwolves. He dishes it to Towns. The third shot of the possession finally falls for him. Towns has got 27.
Man, have they been effective at getting the ball inside.
Russell against Williams. And that one drops for him. Williams has got eight.
And that's his strong suit, the ability to find his way through the D and finish at the rim.
To the middle. Shot is good, and the Los Angeles leads cut to just seven on the basket from Towns.
And defensively, they are on their heels every time the ball comes inside.
Shamet finds Harrell. Pass to Magruder. Williams with the ball, covered by Beasley. Clock at six. And Lou Williams hits from deep.
Well, if you offer no resistance defensively, he's going to knock down the three. It's really that simple, guys.
Outside, Russell. And it's Shamet with the rebound. Clippers leading by 10. Shot on the wing. Here's Magruder. And he gets the whistle. Two free throws coming up. That's on D'Angelo Russell. The Clippers shooting their sixth and seventh free throw attempts tonight. First one falls for him. Doris, you've accomplished so much in your award-winning career. What was your first experience in broadcasting?
Kevin, my first experience was I left coaching, and they put Providence College women's basketball on radio. That was the first ever game I got to call. It was so cool. Tell me yours. What was the very first? Did you study this? How did you get into broadcasting?
I did. Our high school had a radio station, and the first basketball broadcast was underneath the bleachers, looking through popcorn boxes and legs of the people that were standing in the bleachers so that I could see the court from the baseline.
Amazing.
Because that's where the telephone cables were to plug in our equipment.
Wow.
I was 16 years old.
Incredible.
Remembered very well.
Incredible.
Very well.
They're scoring boatloads of buckets. It's raining buckets from inside.
Williams finds Harrell. Leonard with the ball. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot two at the free throw line.
You can see the kind of savvy Kawhi Leonard plays with. This guy makes the defense commit and gets himself to the foul line.
And this is his second trip to the line in the game. And the first one at the line is good.
We are looking at the MVP of the 2014 finals. Can we remember that in that series, Kawhi Leonard shot 60% and he guarded LeBron James?
Jamichael Green, he's checked in for the Clippers. Oh. No good on the second free throw. Timberwolves trail by 8. Here's Crabb, and again it's Minnesota.
Boy, if Allen Crabb is going to make contested shots like this, give him just a tip of the cap, because that is nice.
To the paint. Oh, and the jam by Leonard.
But Kawhi Leonard might be quiet off the court, but on the court, he makes a lot of noise.
And the foul call on Kawhi Leonard. That's foul number 2 for him. So it's Minnesota now. Now Crabb dishes it to Turner. There's 57 seconds left to play in the third. The 9-foot shot. It's hauled in by the Clippers. They've led by as many as 14 points. Leonard attacking. Oh, and the jam by Leonard.
This guy is such an excellent finisher at the rim. He's got incredibly long arms and very strong hands.
The pass to Hernan Gomez. To the inside. Spellman draws contact on the shot, and now a 3-point play chance as he'll head to the line.
Their interior has been inferior defensively. It has got to tighten up.
First trip to the free throw line for him tonight.
One shot.
And that one misses. And so it's Leonard with it. He'll bring it up for the Clippers. They're leading by 8. And the call on the shot that sends him to the line. For Los Angeles, they have gone 5 of 9 at the line. And the first one drops. He makes 1 of 2 that time. Timberwolves trail by 9. There's 21 seconds left in the third. Grab the pass to Spellman. Nice ball movement by Minnesota. 5 on the clock. Here's Okogie. And he goes in for the dunk.
And cutting into the lead with the big one-hand throwdown.
That's how you get your team back into it. And Leonard gets it to go on the assist from Williams. 31 points for Leonard.
And obviously his momentum from the last game has carried over here tonight.
No, I think that's the one thing every player is searching for, consistency. They're giving this guy a chance to carry the offense once again.
The points coming in bunches as we wrap up the third quarter. It's been a good one. Clippers ahead. They're up by 9. And fourth quarter basketball will be coming your way on 2K Sports right after this. And a moment now as we take a look at our State Farm assists of the game.
And he sliced the D wide open with this feed. They had no chance to prevent that basket.
Well, that's what a great pass will do, right? You love the unselfish play.
And this is it. Glad to have you along for this fourth and final quarter. And on the floor for the Clippers here in the fourth, the two stars, George and Leonard, fill up the forward slots. Then it's Ivica Zubac. Then it's Williams. And it's Magruder in a shooting guard. Here's Okogie, defended by George. Turner inside. He's against Williams. He muscles it in through the contact, and they call the foul. He's on his way to the free throw line.
Yeah, these defenders just look a bit overmatched, especially inside.
And that one falls for Turner. Los Angeles leading by 8. To the middle. Here's Leonard. And it's good. Assisting on the play was Williams. Leonard's got 15 points here in the second half.
When you allow good scorers to get uncontested shots at the rim, no wonder you're losing.
Greg, to me, this is simply stated, been a complete lack of defensive attention and focus all night long.
And hard to decide which was better, the pass, the catch, or the slam.
There's no wrong answer. Sensational alley-oop. We play just over 1 minute here in the fourth quarter, and the shot goes in.
Well, you love his effort level, right? Particularly when it's winning time. He is going for the finish.
Passes it to Spellman. Off target from three-point range. L.A. has gotten a positive outcome on 7 of their 14 three-pointers in this game. Not bad at all. And he'll shoot free throws here. Clearly fouled on that shot that time. The whistle blowing. And hard to believe that gruesome injury Paul George suffered, what was it, 5 years ago. Wow.
It's incredible, Kevin, to think for a player to come back from what we expected to be a devastating injury. This is an incredible story for Paul George. He took the time he needed, and consider last year, for much of the season, he was very much involved in that MVP conversation.
And the Timberwolves making a change here. Culver's checked in. Leonard with the steal. And pushing it up, here's Los Angeles. Beverly for three. That shot, no good. And Minnesota now the other way. Culver with it. Leonard's there. The Clippers grab the miss. Leonard's got 7 rebounds in the game. Good work defensively by Turner. Timberwolves trail by 12. And it's Paul George with the foul. That'll be his second foul of the game. Morris is checked in for Lou Williams. The feed to Culver. We're in the fourth quarter here, just under 2.5 minutes gone. Back to Turner. Shot clock at 6. Pass to Okogie. From beyond the arc. That falls. Nice feed that time from Turner. Turner's got assist number 5 here tonight. Now, here is George. He's covered closely. Morris outside. Pass to Beverly. Now George. Back to Beverly. From deep three-point range, and Evan Turner pulls it down. Turner's got his 5th rebound in this one.
Well, when you've been struggling as he has, you love that your teammates have really stepped up and taken the challenge.
Ron Gomez trying to break free. That one falls. That's 7 points for Jarrett Culver.
And how about the balance there from Culver? Really good at staying in control despite the D being all over.
And Beverly kicks to George. Now here's Leonard. Oh, and the jam by Leonard.
This is a small forward who, because he's 230 pounds, can hold his own down in the low post. That is nicely done.
Here's Okogie. The pass to Hernan Gomez. Passes to Okogie. Over Morris. It's hauled in by Zubats. Zubats has got rebound number 7 for him tonight. Now here's Beverly. He's guarded closely. Pass to Morris. For the 3. They get the rebound. Zubats. Good work defensively by Turner. Timberwolves trail by 9. Pass to Hernan Gomez. Culver with it. Shoots a three. It's hauled in by Zubats. Zubats has got 9 rebounds now tonight. Outside Leonard. Beverly, the pass to Zubats. Back to Beverly. Leonard, that's for 2. Herman Gomez grabs the miss. Minnesota's gone 1-3 from outside the arc since we've reached the fourth quarter. A nice shot by Culver.
And that attacking mindset. When Culver sees an opportunity like that, he just grabs it.
Beverly, the pass to Zubats. And here's Beverly. And the pass to George. Misses the 3.
Still looking for his first triple of the half. He had 3 at the break.
Passes it to Okogie. Back to Turner. And that one, good. Turner's got 5 points now this quarter.
I really like the way he's playing in this half. He looks so much more aggressive and confident.
Left side, George. Softly drops in the floater. And the Clippers lead by 7.
Well, Paul George is not just a gifted perimeter shooter. That touch on the interior is impressive.
And the Timberwolves call time here. You have to like what we're seeing so far from Kawhi Leonard.
You've got to take a timeout, take a breath, and come up with a plan for how to stop this guy.
And now we get the chance to present our Jordan Player of the Game, Kawhi Leonard.
And Kevin, it's a no-brainer. He's controlled every aspect of this game, and it's just so fun to see a player perform at a level that's just higher than anyone else out on the floor.
He's really seemed to feed off the hostile environment he's been faced with tonight. He gets a chance now to catch up with the fourth member of our crew, Hall of Famer David Aldridge.
Well, over that last break, Kevin, I got a chance to hear what Ryan Saunders said to the team. He told his guys, the inside game is working, so stick with it. That means posting, slashing, getting to the rim, whatever produces these high percentage looks. Kevin, back to you.
Thank you, David. It's deflected. Inside. Good on that shot, and with that, the Los Angeles lead is cut down now to just 3 on the basket from Culver.
Every time they get scored on during this run, it's come from inside the paint.
Right side, George. Outside, Leonard. Tries from 16. Good on the shot. Leonard's got 41.
I'll tell you, the team is simply riding the hot hand. This guy has been lights out.
Here's Okogie. He's covered by Leonard. Okogie misses. And it's Leonard with the ball. He'll bring it up for Los Angeles. And there's Paul George on the assist by Beverly. Beverly's got assist number 5 here tonight. Russell passes to Towns. Here's Okogie. Zubats defending. Towns against Zubats. Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot 2 free throws.
Well, he's got moves and counter moves inside. Towns makes the defender pick his poison.
The free throw drops for Towns. Williams, he's checked in for the Clippers. That one is no good. And the ability to stretch the floor from the power forward spot, Doris, becoming almost a requirement. That's worked out well for Marcus Morris.
Boy, when he comes into the league, Kevin, 2011, he was viewed as that classic tweener. That at one point was a negative level. The game has now shifted his direction because of his versatility.
And that is a textbook example of how to defend your rim.
That boy, to have someone back there who can erase your mistakes, what a big-time asset defensively.
And that's not nearly the kind of defense that's going to prevent a player of his ability from scoring.
Here's Okogie. Kicks it to Culver. Here's Okogie. The three. They get it back. Russell against Williams. Second chance shot. Russell, no luck. Clippers leading by eight. Right side, Leonard. Leonard draws the double. Morris, left side. There's the triple. Cranes the three-pointer.
Well, this is why Mr. Morris is out there. The ability to drain the shot from long distance and spread the floor.
Guys are looking for a spark here.
Yeah, a cold stretch offensively, for sure. And an eye for an eye. Both teams working to stretch the floor.
Well, that three-point shot just gives you so much room to operate on the offensive end.
Los Angeles calls timeout. Los Angeles has gone into a funk from downtown in the fourth. Only one of their five three-pointers has found the bottom of the bucket. Leonard looking over the floor, and he uses the glass on the layup. Leonard's got 43 points.
Well, Kawhi Leonard is 230 pounds of nothing but pure strength. What a finish at the rim.
Russell passes to Towns. Fouled on the shot and picks up 2 points, so one free throw coming up.
What a terrific play by just a tremendous all-around player. This guy makes it look easy.
And Towns no good on that one. Clippers leading by eight. Leonard inside. Can't hit that one. And it's the Timberwolves taking it the other way. Culver dishes to Johnson. It's hauled in by the Clippers. 1:29 left here in the fourth quarter. Here's Williams. Scores the bucket. He's 7 for 11 and continues to look good.
Well, this is what you're trying to do. Put the game away.
And he hasn't forced much tonight, Greg. I love the efficiency he's giving to them.
Here's Towns. Good, and it's Russell picking up the assist. 34 points for Karl Anthony Towns.
And this, to me, is important for Karl Anthony Towns. We know he has a terrific perimeter game, but I like to see him take charge on the interior first.
Bounce pass from Williams. Leonard draws the double. Pass to Zubats. There's the three. And again, it's the Clippers from deep.
And now as the clock ticks down, this is going to end up as a solid victory here for the Clippers.
Starting five must have been happy to get so much help from the reserves in this game.
And they not only lightened the load, the subs did nothing less than guarantee a win.
And so checking out the record for these guys, tonight will mark win number 37 for them on the year.
And this will be their third win in three tries against these guys. They match up so well.
And we watched one guy all night long, guys, and looking at the stats just confirms what a dominant game he had. What a night tonight it was for Kawhi Leonard.
What you love about his performance is that he is simply taking what the defense allows and then making the most of his opportunities.
6 second difference between the shot and game clock. A nice shot by George.
Saw the opportunity to put this away and did not turn it down.
Yeah, playing with great energy and great effort. And as a coach, you'd love to see this from your team every single night. He is too good a mid-range shooter to leave him that open.
Now Leonard. So it's Los Angeles winning this one easily. A solid win on the road for them. This building was dead silent by the time GA this one wound down.
And that's what you want to do. Take the crowd out of it by crunch time. Don't give them any chance to lift their team up at the finish.